Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Nomni Factory. In the last episode, we were preparing to get Pulsating Polymer Clay set up, but we figured out we actually needed the Paralyze Oven. So, we are going to get the Paralyze Oven today and get DML set up as well. I'm going to get some LV machine holes. Okay, there's our 7 LV machine holes. Okay, now we will start getting stuff for the Paralyze Oven. Okay, there's our input bus. Okay, there's our output bus. Next, we need an input hatch and the output hatch. Okay, there's our input hatch. And there is our output hatch. Okay, next we need an LV energy hatch. Okay, and there's our LV energy hatch. Okay, and there's our maintenance hatch. Okay, and there is our muffler hatch. Okay, next we need the UOV machine casing and the Paralyze Oven controller block. I'll be right back. Okay, and there is our controller block. There is our quest. Okay, so I think I'm gonna build the Paralyze Oven like right here in this little chunk. So I'll be right back once I'm done building it. Okay, and there is our Paralyze Oven all set up. Now all we need to do is make some Colo Coke so we can get the phenol for next year's circuit boards. So I'm gonna go do that and I'll be right back. Okay, and hello, I am back, and I made this fluid heater, and I have it hooked up to this infinite water source. This creates steam, basically, which goes into the Pyrolyze Oven, so we can get our phenol from our coal. Okay, so I've switched up how this fluid heater works. We have it right next to our machines here for easy access to power. It still generates steam the same way, but we have this lever here so we can input steam into the paralysis oven when we want. So yeah, that's basically all I've changed. So let's go ahead and make up some phenol. Okay, the oven is done running. We got the coke and then the phenol, which we need for tier 2 circuits. So let's just go ahead and craft up 2 tier 2 circuits. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is make the circuit boards, which requires a coated circuit board and then some phenol. Then we get the phenol substrate. There's our quest. There's another quest. Okay, I've been working to get this quest right here, the gallium arsenide, because we need that in order to get diodes, which we need for circuits. So, now we can start crafting up some diodes. Okay, so in order to make the diodes, we have to make it into the basic assembling machine with the gallium arsenide dust, and then the fine copper wire. This will give us our diodes if we wait a little while. There's our quest. Well, there's our first 2 MV circuits. There's the quest. There's another quest. Okay, and there is our first MV machine, the chemical reactor. Now the only thing that we need, there's a quest. Now the only thing that we need in order to automate pulsating polymer clay is a MV transformer, energy converter. I just need to make up one more of these circuits. So I'll be right back once I have all of this stuff. Okay, and there is our MV energy converter. Should get a quest. Yep, there's the quest. Okay, so we should have everything To automate pulsating polymer clay now. Let me just go back into my test world to make sure. Okay, so I think the only thing that we need now is the limited item filter and then the loot fabricator, because I have the automation for pulsing polymer clay set up in this test world. So, yes, I think we'll focus on getting the loot fabricator first, then the limited item filter. So, I will see you once I have one of those, or have progress towards those. Okay, so if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm trying to get this Enderman data model, which needs this hellish matter for the Blaze data model, so we can get the extra terrestrial matter for the Enderman model. So that's what I'm doing right now. So we need the Enderman model for Ender Pearls for our pulsating polymer clay automation. So there's our quest. Okay, there's two blank data models, and then we put one here for our Blaze data model. Okay, there's our Enderman data model. Okay, there is our loot fabricator. There's our quest. Now, the only thing that we need for automating pulsing polymer clay is a limited item filter. So, I will see you in a little while. Okay, so I have what we need to do in order to get the limited item filter. Starting in the top left with the MV Electrolyzer. The next we'll need Chrome, the MV Mixer, and so on. I just have it in like a like snake thing with the limited item filter being the product of all of this. So the first thing that we're going to work towards is the MV Electrolyzer, and so on and so forth. So yeah. Okay, so before we do anything, I think we should upgrade our power by getting these reinforced upgrade kits. And also getting these fuel catalyzers for our steam dynamos. Okay, so what we need for the reinforced upgrade kit is we need Electrum, which I do not have. So let's just go ahead and make up like 64. There's our quest for gold, I guess. Okay, there's our reinforced upgrade kits along with the quest. Let's go ahead and apply these to our dynamos. 1, 2, 3. Now, they should be. Yeah, the maximum power is 400 RF now, which is 800 RF between the two of these. But this cable can only do 512, so we'll have to upgrade this cable to conductive. Wait, no, energetic alloy. So let me just go get the fuel catalyzers that we need as well, and then we can start upgrading the cable. Okay, and there is our energetic alloy energy conduits. Let me just go apply them to all of our system. Oh, hey, there's a quest as well. Nice. Okay, there is our fuel catalyzers. There's our quest. Let's go and apply these. Okay, and there's our new MV power line. So now we can go ahead and start connecting some of our MV machines to it once we make those MV machines. So the first machine that we are going to make is the MV electrolyzer. So let's just go ahead and get started on that. And there is our advanced electrolyzer. There is our quest as well. Let's go ahead and plug this in. Oh, we got this quest as well. It's nice. Okay, so the next thing that we need is this advanced mixer. So So let's just go and get some of these parts. Okay, and there is our MV and mixer along with the quest. Let's just go and plug these in. Okay, so the next thing that we need is gonna be this vanadium steel. So let's just go and make up a couple. Let's see, vanadium steel dust makes it made in a mixer with chrome, vanadium, and steel dust. All right, let me just go do that real quick. Okay, and there is our dust. Next, we just need to smelt it in the blast furnace. Okay, and there is our ingot along with our quest. Okay, so the next thing that we need is this cutting machine. So, yeah, let me just go and get all the stuff for this. Okay, and there is our advanced cutting machine. There is our quest. Let's just go and plug this in. Okay, so next we need the silicon balls. I already have it smelting in the blast furnace, so we just need to wait on that. And there's our silicon boule, along with the quest. Okay, so the next thing that we need is the silicon wafer. And you make that in the cutting saw with the silicon boule and water. Okay, and there's our silicon wafers, along with our quest. Okay, so the next thing that we need to do in order to get our limited item filter is to get this Z logic controller, which takes solarium, the silicon wafer, block of red alloy, a circuit, zombie head, and that's all. So let me go craft up all this stuff and I'll be right back. So the solarium you get from alloy smelting gold and soul sand. So. Okay, and there's our Z logic controller. Okay, and there's our limited item filter. Okay, so I've already set up the automation of play right here a little while ago since I need a lot of it. Basically, I'll just show you how it works. You have this infinite cobblestone generator. It goes through this forge hammer, which turns it into gravel, this one which turns it into sand, this one which turns it into dust. Then the dust gets mixed with this water from the infinite water source and this chemical reactor, and that makes our clay. So that is all that I've done so far. I don't really have it hooked up at the moment, as you can see. So let's just go ahead and make our So let's go ahead and set up our quartz production, because we need that for our resident classroom. First off, it goes three, four, I mean no, two forge hammers right here. Then a cobblestone generator on the top. Gives cobblestone to here. So next, what we need to do, I think, is to put down a electrolyzer. Hang on, let me just go double check my testing world real quick. Okay, so we don't put an electrolyzer down, we put a electric furnace. Then we can put our electrolyzer down. Okay, next we need a extractor right here. And then a advanced chemical reactor right here. Let's go and plug these in. One and two. Next, what we'll need is an alloy smelter and an electric furnace. The electric furnace goes on top, and that goes to the side. Then we hook up a fluid conduit from the extractor to the advanced chemical reactor. Okay, next we need to set up our loot fabricator and simulation chamber, or ender pearls for the resident ender, or the resident clathrate. So we put a loot fabricator right there, then our simulation chamber on the top, and put the Enderman data model in here. Okay, so there is our DML part setup for our ender pearls. Okay, so I've gone ahead and finished the entire system. Basically, just adding some conduits and stuff around. Basically, this is where the pulsating polymer clay would be outputted. And so, First things first, I just need to do a test run to make sure it all works. Okay, so I did like a test run of the entire thing, and it looks like it's all working fine. It doesn't really look that good, but you know. Alright, so let's just go and re-enable this. Actually, there is one more thing I need to do, which is get this and put it into the loot fabricator and autocraft the ender pearls. So yeah, that's basically the only thing I need to do. Now the system should be running. I'll see you guys once we have some more polymer play, if we get any. Okay, there's our first bit of pulsating polymer clay. So now we have the entire thing automated. Okay, so I think that'll be all for today's episode. I spent a lot of time making this, so hopefully you'll like and subscribe. Also, in the next episode, I will be setting up new Zomatic dynamos for better power generation. I'll also be continuing to work on DML stuff. So yeah, that's all for today, and goodbye.